always said I had a stash. I said, it's not even a stash, but I tell you I have a stash.
Tasha, when somebody says stash, that's like I got two or three more books like in a book bag or somewhere. That's three luggages full of books. And you over here hemming and hawing about me saying filling up one more bin. That's not a stash. That's a haul. That's, come on.
That's semantics.
Y'all, let me show y'all something. Look at your girl. Look at your girl. This an addendum.
That's only three bags. No.
Those
carry-ons, first
no.
of all.
Listen.
Those are the essential homeschooling books right here, textbooks. And these are all of the best children's books you ever find, okay? No library has a collection.
Let me show y'all this. Don't even talk. You don't get to talk.
Okay.
After all of that, hemming and hawing. That's why she couldn't agree to the bin. Watch out. That's why she couldn't agree to the bin. Look. Watch out. Watch out. You're out. Go on. I smell plantains cooking. I smell plantains cooking. They read all of these books. Our children have read these books. Every single book in there, these kids have read several times.
1 year old read the book.
She can't read, Cam.
But she will read. Our kids read at 3 years old. She got only two more years left to start reading. So we need these books.
Look at my face. How y'all feel?
Fire!
How y'all feel?
Fire!
All right.
All right.
All right.
All right.
Fired up.
Fired up.
Fired up.
Fired up.
Who are we?
God Squad.
Who are we?
God Squad.
All right.
All right.
All right.
All right.
Fired up.
Fired up.
Fired up.
Fired up.
Who we represent? Who we represent?
The sweet Jesus Christ.
I said, who we represent? Who we represent?
The sweet Jesus Christ.
All right.
All right.
All right.
All right.
Fired up.
Fired up.
Fired up.
Fired up.
Clap it up.
That's a video.
That's it. We're done. What?
I'm still salty about not being able to bring all my books.
I don't know which books I want to take because we have so many good ones. And John is making me. He wants to get rid of all of them. Why? Why would you want to do something like that?
Look, just first of all, instead of being salty, just focus on like being able to cross this thing, and then we'll talk about what you being salty about.
I'm you know professional what I mean? Crossing this river. I don't even need my arms up. I'm just gonna walk like a Yikes. Supermodel.
Yikes.
Across this log. Go ahead before I fall.
You said you was about to walk like a supermodel?
Yeah, walk, not stay.
Don't supermodel stop and turn? In there, like that's just real life. Like that's what's happening to us. So you saw us packing up and leaving.
Like, yeah, and it can be stressful. And there can be conflict.
Yeah.
Like it's not just like, oh, we packed this. This is our packing list and we got on the plane. Our packing list and we got on the plane. No.
Especially for us dudes that like order and organization. You know, and like, you know, hey, we got to make sure that like we're not about to go over, you know what I'm saying, and have a bunch of stuff. And then the women, it's like, well, we need this and we need that.
No, this is the same person that brought two tuxedo suits, though, and two live animals. Didn't you bring two tuxedos and some suede shoes?
It's sort of like the Cascade Dishes commercial.
But you're talking about going over and things that we don't actually need.
Right, but it's sort of like the Cascade Dishes commercial. Like, remember when Cascade Dishes were like...
He made me bring five dresses. Like, we're going to have dinner with the president of Togo or something.
Cascade Dishes. The point is, what I'm saying
Cascade
is...
Cascade Dishes.
Yes. And the commercial, they already told you how you wash dishes is, wash the cups, wash all the clean type stuff first, and then do the pots and the oil last. But then at the end of the commercial, because they was using Cascade...
Oh, my God.
You know what I'm saying? It was like he found out, the dude that was washing the dishes, he found out... Like, yo, actually, it's a cup left with a bunch of, or like a pot left with grease in it. And then she was like, well, the thing is, you could just throw this pot in there with the grease, dog, because it's cascade. All I'm trying to tell you is, the main rule is, let's figure this out and be organized about this. But when you get to the end and you figure it out, you might have a pound or two. You
add can go ahead and throw. Add more books.
One extra book, not gonna do nothing. But if you just throw in like one little outfit for former wear, just in case,
because
you didn't have none.
He threw in five, and he threw in some suede purple Brooks Brothers shoes
First of all, we do all our stuff. First of all, we do all our stuff unedited, unrehearsed, so y'all can get real life. But we do kind of like a little bit try to talk to our ideas, so it won't be scatterbrained, so that we won't waste a lot of time. But I'm going to tell you this right here. This woman's going to spring this on me right now to try to attack me. I'm going to tell y'all that she over here trying to attack me in public.
Your suede shoes.
About bringing blue suede shoes. Let me tell you this. The thing is, I could have left them, man. I could have left them in the spirit. But I had just got them boys. I had just got them, dude. And the thing is, I'm giving away stuff all the time. I'm letting go of stuff all the time, but I had just got on only one time.
This suede shoe's about to get given
to
away.
A wedding for her friend. To a wedding for her friend. You know what I'm saying? So I got fly for a wedding for her friend and worn one time. I'm like, I just need to wear these one time on the farm. I need to wear these one time while I'm over here planting. I need to wear these one time while I'm planting these yams.
Oh, no. No. He's going to end up giving these away to one of his friends here.
But I'm going to wear them one time while planting yams.
No.
Or playing soccer.
Don't get them dirty.
Or playing soccer. Yes.
Oh, my God.
I'm going to play soccer in the boys. You better get it on video, and I'll give them away.
Nobody wants them once you play soccer.
They're going to still be straight.
Nobody's going to want them then.
It is, y'all. Who going to ask the first question, me or you?
I ask you.
All right, what is it?
The first question is, did you have fun moving? Were you happy? Now you repeat the question.
The first question that you got for me, okay.
Did you enjoy moving and packing?
Did I enjoy it? Yo, these boys got a space to move out of my chest. They might shine one, you know they challenge it. You want to get in the kitchen. I'm not going to stand out. Like, I got a job to do. And I'm trying to enjoy what I'm doing. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm trying to have fun. I'm trying to have a great experience. And I'm trying to say, like, things are great for me. But things aren't really going to be great for me unless I don't think they're going right. So I'm trying to add humor in. I'm trying to keep everybody a team together. I'm trying to keep everybody working really hard. Yeah. And at the same time, I got a little bit of stress going on. But if I can bear a little bit of stress in order for people to kind of have fun, then I can. I'll tell you this. I was able to be like, okay, I'm stressed out a little bit. I'm stressed. Because I want this to go well. Like, I don't want to lose. I don't want to suck. So I had a lot of stress. But the thing in and of itself and what we were trying to achieve is the thing that added the adventure to it, out of making sure that somebody else had a bona fide sense of happiness.
Yeah.
So was I happy? I would say yes, because I was totally happy, because here I am, I'm a Nigerian, I'm finally going home for the first time. My dad didn't do that for me. That's just fact. My mom's, nobody did that for me. Like, the father had to step in when I knew him and do that for me and get me here. So, like, and I'm 40, and I tried, y'all. Oh, I tried. Not like talking about it like people talk about it. Like, I actually bona fide tried. It didn't happen. So for me, I'm going to say things that a man can feel. I was very happy. I actually was, because I can anticipate the liberation of me and a goal, a lifelong goal, right? That's like asking, a quarterback or a running back or a wide receiver or a cornerback or a safety or a linebacker, like one of them big time positions, like that get put on the spot at the Super Bowl or the NFL, the NBA World Championship. Like, you asking him, were you happy to get to the Super Bowl? Were you happy to get to the World Championship? Were you happy to get to the FIFA World Championship? Were you happy to get to the Olympics? Absolutely. I was very happy. But then you got to ask a secondary question. Well, was you stressed? I was. Yeah. And in some ways, you will see that. Some ways you'll see that, and then you'll see me trying to relieve that stress for others and for myself by, like, doing my best to, like, be good-natured. How can you be loving and kind? I understand, as a person who played athletics my whole life, it might not be enjoyable, but the end, when I get that W, is going to be enjoyable. Bottom line.
So, next question is...
Wait, I get to ask you a question in the middle.
Oh, okay. Go ask me a question.
All right. So, my question is for you... is, okay, and yeah, I want y'all to pay attention. This is complex. It's like a little deeper than what you think.
Oh,
it is.
No,
simple.
Keep it simple.
All right, then, fine. B. What is the one thing you would leave to exchange out for the one thing that you would keep, that you would have put in the tape?
No, Emmanuel, Africa room.
One thing that I would leave, that I would exchange out for something else, would be Instapot. I know you don't want to. Listen,
wow.
You can cook rice in a pot. I don't know if you forgot this in America, but you can do things very simply that they created large, heavy, overpriced appliances for. It's not the end of the world if it doesn't.
The luxury. The luxury. As we keep going straight here.
Yeah, isn't it beautiful?
Yeah. Okay. She took me down a path like, we should walk down this path and do it. I never been here before, and then I'm having to lead the way, even though she's been here before. But it's starting to get kind of slim up in here. Kind of safari-ish, kind of green mamba-ish.
Kind of green mamba-ish.
So the Instapot, you changing it out.
What I would have replaced with it.
No, here she go.
Was more books. I'm going to tell you the truth. And I think about this every day.
That right there wasn't interesting.
I don't care. Listen, the books I wish I could have brought, number one. Was,
okay, let me ask you a question then. Okay,
I'm not done.
Pause.
You asked
no,
me a
I
question.
No, I get to pause. How many more books could you have brought for the exchange of an Instapot? That's the rule. Like, whatever
okay,
you take out.
About five more. So I would have brought Powerful Days.
That's not a book. That's a book, but it's actually
Photojournalism by Charles Moore.
Right.
It's just of the Civil Rights Movement. And okay. It really inspires me. And
got
I think about it maybe
right,
like three times
okay,
a
that's
week.
One. Keep moving.
I wish I could see that book. And I'm going to ask somebody to send me Powerful Days.
No. See.
Another thing is wish I could have brought some like coffee table art books like my Modigliani, my Picasso book.
This woman talking about... I got to take it number two. This woman over here talking about this. I'm going to tell you what I'm going to explain to y'all what's going on. See, y'all not going to peep it. Y'all not, no, pause. I'm going to explain to y'all what's going on. I'm stiff arm her. You see my arm? She's getting stiff arm. I'm explaining to y'all what's going on so y'all can get it for real. This woman over here talking about when I take a dump and read the Vibe magazine, I forgot those types of things.
No,
honestly, it is. Y'all, listen, the general public of east side of Detroit like me is going to take the Vibe machine, Vibe magazine. Stop. The east side of Detroit like me is going to take the Vibe magazine or the New Jet or something in there. What she's going to take is an art book from Modigliani or Picasso to look at while she take a dump.
Charles Moore, Powerful Days too. Okay? I wish I had brought that. I did bring Henri Cartier-Bresson.
Okay.
I did remember
that.
I
don't even know who that is.
Or
you know what? He must have been irrelevant. Because I don't know him. I know names like the baby.
So that's my answer. If you want to know my
answer. We know the baby.
I would have. Oh,
we know Kanye. We know Kim. We know Jigga, Beyonce. We even know Mary J. back again. We know Mary J. back again. What we don't know is that name that you just said. Irrelevant. Stuff that himself was not timeless. Because it couldn't last. Okay, fine. You got a question for me? Thanks for keeping it short. All right, what's your question for me?
Okay, my question.
I can't down your answer though. Honestly, y'all, that's the one thing that I will regret is that I was pushing hard on blocking the books.
Guess what my advice to you is? It's probably time for you to start scanning pages. Start start scanning pages, dude. If you want it that bad, start scanning those pages, man. Okay. You said that new iPad that you're getting got the scan capability, right? There you go. There you go.
I don't understand how you get to take two whole live animals.
Does the iPad have scanning capabilities?
Are you taking two?
Does the iPad have scanning?
Live animals that can't.
Does the iPad have scan capabilities? We or no? We or no?
We're gonna sell those dogs.
Does the iPad?
We're not taking the dogs with us.
Does the iPad have scanning capability? We or no?
Olumba.
Does the iPad have scanning capability?
We get 18 pieces of luggage. Tasha, I got.
You guys see how they really do? They never. They can't ever ask you a question.
What are you gonna do with the other pieces of luggage?
You see how this is a class right now in how women operate. They will not answer your question.
18.
You ask them a direct question, they will not answer it. Does the iPad have scanning capabilities?
What does that have to do with anything?
You see how women are?
But out of all things, not for her. Not her little art books, but for all things, what happened is our kids are here now and they are rereading books and they asking for books that they already read to reread and they asking for other books. We're downloading books, but we finding out that because America and the world is in the place that they in, the books that you downloading are totally trash. You know, totally trash. Kids is blowing. The quality is bad. The kids are blowing through the books in 5 minutes, but the subject matter, they slipping stuff in, is not
propaganda.
Cool. You know what I'm saying?
We don't want that.
One thing I would say that I didn't think we was going to get used of, and that the kids was probably not going to get used of, because I thought we was going to be running around. We are running around, doing stuff, building the house. Our kids are farming everything. But in our free time, our downtime, we sit down. We'll download, like, I don't know, an old school show like Little House on the Prairie or something, and watch one show like a week. But they are actually, that she was right about that. And I was wrong about that. When y'all gonna see the clip, or y'all already saw it, maybe it's the intro, I'm not sure. The point is, y'all see the clip, I'm like, what's up with these books? And I would agree with her books. That we could have, but I still don't think that you can exchange that for the Instapot. It's not fair for you to answer that question because the Instapot.
It's a pot. That's pause, electric.
But pause. Hold up. The reason why it doesn't count and why I'm telling y'all why that we got stressed out into the video. What I'm saying is the books are going to a different box. And your box with the books was already 50 pounds. So you got to take something out of the book box to put more books in. You can't go into the.
That's not what you said. Next question. So my question to you is, did you miss all the stuff that you had to give away? Did you miss? We had to give a lot of stuff away to Salvation Army or to friends.
Like what?
Talking
about the laser gun toys?
No.
I don't care about none of that.
This man had a tie addiction. Soccer? He had a tie addiction, which is unlike anything I've ever seen in my life.
My gosh.
He would go buy, like, silk and golden thread, Brooks Brothers ties, Talbot, I don't know what they are. And
Bob Talbot. She talking about the Bob Talbot best of class.
He would spend more on a
that's on the robber for
a slip of silk tie than I would spend on an entire dress.
That wasn't the day before we left.
I don't even buy dresses.
I evolved. That was some old oppression slave thinking. I evolved. Why don't you hop on my back?
Because I'm gonna fall.
I evolved, y'all.
He's
kidding
me.
Get off.
Okay.
We on the rock side. We could just chill right here. You're not getting bit. Just tell me if you're getting bit or not. Yeah, it's nice. It's actually straight.
So he had an addiction to ties.
And suits.
And Brooks Brothers suits.
That was the life I was living.
And he gave them all away.
I did.
So how do you feel about giving away all your we gave away tools. You like tools too. You like tools.
Yeah.
Giving away all this stuff that you had accumulated and collected over the years. Because it kind of hurt me personally to see those ties. Her. Some of those were pieces of artwork.
And that's why me and her kind
of
like...
Some of those were rather artistic.
We're like kind of... We're almost like a walking... We're kind of hypocritical, like a walking conundrum.
And he looks so good in them Brooks
Brothers My wife be like, how could you spend all those money on things and keep them so nice and keep it so together, but be able to give it up so easy? And that's my answer. Like, it wasn't, how did I feel or could I do that easily? Yes. Because that thing never actually held value for me. I like to look nice. I like to have nice things. But the actual thing in of itself, the only value that it had was that for me, I could be able to express myself in the way that I wanted to express myself.
At that moment in life.
And what the Father was trying to do through me. And so I'm like, I'm going to express myself at the highest level that what I can express myself with what he's saying and what I'm doing. And I want to look nice doing it. But at the same time, it actually doesn't have an intrinsic value itself. However, since I'm not expressing myself in that way no more, it might be somebody that still, that the Father is still saying, can express themselves in that way. And so I was able to be able to give it up. Eventually, let me tell you an ironic thing that did kind of hurt. I'm going to keep it real with y'all. I had hope to be able to give them to somebody, right?
Yeah.
And that's how the Father kind of will convict you and kind of get you in your humility. Yeah, I felt like that. Like, I'm just going to give them to somebody. But of course, I probably was going to try to extract some credit for that. Mm. You feel me? And this is what the Father would do. You know what I mean? See, I'm doing what you do now. But I went the wrong way. His thing was, he going to retrospect me and say, oh, you think you all that because you could get this up and not really covet it or not care about it and just move on. What happened was at the last second, the stuff that when we were throwing stuff away, we were putting stuff in bags and it was happening so quick because we literally, y'all, like right before we left, well, you'll see it in the very next video, not in this episode, but probably the next episode. It was like getting down to the second, to the hour. It actually got down to the second. It literally got down to the second and we missed that second three times. I had two dudes that I was going to give it to that I was like, they can use them because they're going into that career, whatever. But they were totally mismatched with me in terms of like their size. We started throwing out black bags and the kids were involved because it was just that type of thing. Like, everybody got to get involved and if we going to meet our deadlines, which I was pushing. And y'all going to see it in the video. I'm the one with the clipboard like, do this now. Hurry up. We got to hurry up because, hey, we was already behind. Like, already late. And I'm always late. So I know what it feels like to be late. And I know when you actually running late. And in the midst of it, man, the black bags that we put them in, either me, somebody, the kids, mistaked it as trash. Them boys got thrown away. And when I went to grab them.
They in a dumpster.
I went to grab the three bags that I thought it was. Like, oh, here go the three bags of suits. And I've been looking at them for the last 2 days.
Like,
let me just go
clothes.
Drop them off.
I
opened up. It was baby clothes. And one of them was total trash. One of
them
was like.
Debris.
That had been sitting there like debris, like paper. And then the other two was like baby clothes and stuff. I'm like, how, dude?
Gone.
In the, not some Salvation Army, not nothing. Dang. It was tragic. Like bona fide, literally in the Detroit City incinerator, dude. And that's when I was like, that's when I guess I was going to get sick because I was like, I could have extracted some sort of
acknowledgement.
Somebody would have to say, man, he gave me 15 Brooks Brothers suits and, you know, he gave me about $20,000 worth of. No. And then I'd be like, yeah, I gave him $20,000. No, literally.
Hey, store up your treasures in heaven.
Amen.
This stuff doesn't matter.
All right. This and that. It's like crisscross ain't coming off right. No, shake it out. Suck it a turn around, but they can't run like this. Suck it a turn around, but they can't run like this. Suck it a turn around, but they can't run like this. Suck it a turn around, but they can't. Cause I'm gonna make it, 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 make it. Believe that, baby.